give you an analogy to help you to understand this. Brother, you, yeah, brother. Brother, can you please come? Come, brother. You. Yes, you. Come up here. Yes, very good. Come up here, sir. Come up. Come up. Very good. Come up. Very good. Please, here, sir. Thank you. What's your name, sir?
Francis D'Souza.
Francis D'Souza. Very good, Francis. Francis, very good. I got something for you here, Francis. I want you to put this on. This is from Jerusalem. This is from Jerusalem, but this is a typical cloak that a male wears. Let me show you how it looks like. Brother, hold. Open it up. It's the other way around. Okay, can you hold it up, brother? Hold it up. This is a typical cloak that the men wear. This is something interesting about a cloak. You see here, the Jewish Torah, the words, the Jewish Torah. And this is the cloak that the man wears. And the cloak has got four fringes. The cloak, this is a cloak, it's called a prayer shawl. In Hebrew, it's called talit. Say talit. Talit. This is a typical cloak that the man wears. And the cloak has got four fringes. Here, that's one. This is two. Over there, brother. Three, four. Can you see the four fringes? Yes? Four fringes. Okay, very good. Brother, you'll be my Jesus. Stand here in the middle. Turn and look in front. This is how he would look, okay? He'd be wearing this with the, notice, the similarity with the stole of the Catholic priest, yes? Over the head, okay? He's having the fringe. Now, this is Jesus. Assume now for the purpose, I'm showing this visually to you so that you can catch this. And this is very important, okay? It says, she came up from behind him and touched the fringe of his clothes. And many people have this idea that this woman just touched a part of the clothes that Jesus was wearing. No, that's not true. The woman specifically reached out for a piece of the cloth. Matthew chapter 9, this particular item is referenced to again and again. Matthew chapter 9 verse 18 to 21. And then suddenly a woman who'd been suffering from hemorrhage for 12 years came up behind him and touched the fringe of his cloak. And she said, if only I touch the fringe, I will be made well. Matthew chapter 14 verse 34 to 36. When they had crossed over, they came to the land of Gennesaret. And the people of that place recognized Jesus. They sent word throughout the region and brought all who were sick and begged him that they might even touch the fringe of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. Mark chapter 6 verse 54 to 56. When he got out of the boat, everyone recognized him and began to bring mats, the sick on mats wherever he was, and they begged him they might even touch the fringe of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. Mark chapter 6 verse 56. All who touched the fringe of his cloak were healed. Luke chapter 8 verse 44. She came up behind and touched the fringe of his cloak, and immediately she was healed. This is the fringe. This is a typical cloak that the Jewish man wears. And this is the hem of the garment. And this is the fringe. Fringe. This is the hem. The cloak, the prayer shawl is called a talit. Talit. The Jewish man, every time he prays, he wears it and then he bows down. Shema Israel. Adonai. Shema Israel, Adonai. Shema Israel, Adonai. He prays. Every time he prays. The talit has got four hems. This hem is called tzitzit. Repeat after me. Tzitzit. The tzitzit has got four knots. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four knots. And there are four knots. And it's not by accident. Huh? Each of it has got four knots. And this is done specifically according to Mosaic law. Mosaic law. Why? Because in the book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 37 to 41, the Lord said to Moses, speak to the Israelites and tell them to put fringes on the corner of their garments throughout the generation and put a blue cord, a blue thread on the fringe of each corner. So there are four fringes. There is a blue cord on each of the four corners. Put a blue cord. Say blue cord. Blue thread. The blue thread is intertwined within the tzitzit. Intertwined within the tzitzit. Why blue cord? You have the fringes so that when you see it, you will remember all the commands of the Lord and do them and not follow the lust of your own heart or your own eyes. You shall remember and do all the commands and you shall be holy to God. What is the blue thread? The command of God. The word of God. The word of God. What is the blue thread? The word of God. Now you know why the woman reached and touched the fringe. She was just not reaching and touching any part of the body. She knew the word of God. She knew in Malachi, Malachi chapter 4 verse 2. Hold here, brother. Hold here. Malachi chapter 4 verse 2, the Bible says, and you shall revere my name, for the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings. Say with me, healing in his wings. Say that. Let me show you the wings. Brother, raise your right hand and left hand. Raise it up. No, this way. Open. Open your hands. Open. No, 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 no. Don't let go. Yeah, don't let go. Stretch out. Open up, brother. Left and right. Left and right. Yes. What is that? The wings. Can you see the wings? This is the wings. Where is the healing? In the wings. There is healing in the wings. This woman, put the hands down, brother. This woman knew the word of God. It's not a coincidence. Not just random, she simply touched. Turn around, brother. He will be Jesus. I will be the woman. The Bible says, she came up from behind him. She had a very specific goal to reach and touch. She reached and touched the fringe, the hem of his garment. The moment she touched, power went out. And instantly, she was healed. Where is the healing? In the word of God. In the blue thread. Where is the healing? In the blue thread. Say, wow. You know what is our problem? You are lazy to read the word. Tell the person sitting next to you, don't be lazy. You need to know the key. Say amen. When you know the key, the healing is yours. It is for this reason Jesus turned and said, daughter, your faith has healed you. Faith what? Faith in the word. He knew instantly. You know why? Because the Bible says so many people rushing around Jesus. Nobody reached and touched the hem except this woman. Why? Only she knew. Today you have the key. Yes? Do you have the key? Where? In your hand. In your hand. Where's the word of God? Lift up the Bible. Lift up your Bible. Lift up your Bible. Lift it up. If you don't lift up your hand, lift up your Bible, okay? Only lift up your Bible. If you don't have a Bible, after this session, by hook or by crook, go and buy a Bible. Say amen. Amen. Why? This is your key. Lift up your Bible and say, this is the living word of God. It is alive and active. It is the source of my healing. The moment I believe, the moment I believe, the faith is activated. I receive my healing in Jesus' name. If you don't have your Bible, you better go and make sure you buy one now. Amen? Thank you, brother. Praise the Lord. Brother, can you do me a favor? Can you please fold it for me and just put it there for me? This is the key, friends. Many people think for a long time that this lady is just some random healing. No, it's just healing in the word. It's healing in the word of God. The Bible tells us in Psalm 107, verse 19 to 20, they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them in their distress. They cried out to the Lord in their trouble. He saved them in their distress. How? He sent his word and healed them. Say amen. Amen. How did he do it? He sent his word. He sent his word and healed them from their destruction. Exodus chapter 15, verse 22 to 27. Exodus chapter 15, verse 22 to 27. It tells about the people of Israel coming out of the Red Sea, and they were wandering in the wilderness of Shur. Say with me, wilderness of Shur. It's a desert. Wilderness of Shur. They were wandering in the wilderness of desert. In the desert. 3 days in the wilderness, they had no water. How long no water? 3 days in the wilderness, no water. 3 days. 3 days in the wilderness, there was no water. No water. They came to a place called Mara. They could not drink the water of Mara because the water of Mara was bitter. That is why it was called Mara. I come from Malaysia, and in Malaysia, the word Mara means angry. So they were very angry because there was no water. No, there was water. The water they drank was bitter. They were very angry. They were upset. So what did they do? They complained. Again, you see, the key is in your mouth. They could have believed. Am I right? Because they had seen God do signs and wonders to bring them out of Egypt. Am I right? What's the big deal with the water? But no, good Catholics, yes. Small problem and big complaint. No faith. They started to complain, saying, what can we drink? What will we drink? And Moses cried out to the Lord, and the Lord showed him a piece of wood. Say this with me. The Lord showed him a piece of wood. Say it again. Where was the wood? It was there. It was there. The wood was already there. The wood didn't fly from Dubai, take Emirates airline and come there in the middle of the desert. The wood was already there. But you know what is the problem? When you're going through the trouble, you cannot see the wood. The wood is already there. Say that with me. People have the wood, but they're still running for healing. Somebody says healing coming to Mumbai, everybody will run to Mumbai. Some say healing coming to Bangalore, everybody will run to Bangalore. Why are you running after healing? The word is already there. What is the word? The word of God. It's already there. The Lord showed him the wood. The Lord showed him the wood. He threw the wood into the water and the water became sweet. The water became sweet. The water changed from bitter to sweet. And there the Lord made them a statute and ordinance, and there he put them to the test. And this is what the Lord said. If you will listen carefully to the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right and give heed to his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will not bring any of the diseases upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord who heals you. Say amen. Amen. That means if you obey the word of God, you will not get sick. If you obey the commandment, if you listen to the voice of the Lord your God, do what is right, give heed to his commandments, I will heal you. Much of the problem is because we cannot obey. And after that, the Bible says, then they came to Elim. Say Elim. And in Elim, there was 12 springs of water and 70 palm trees, and they camped there by the water. Say Shur. Say Shur. Wilderness of Shur. Say Elim. Say Shur. Say Elim. In Shur is a desert. The water is bitter. Shur is a desert. The water is bitter. Elim has got 12 springs of water. 12 springs of water. 70 palm trees. What is God trying to do? When he takes you through the problem, he's trying to teach you something. Say amen. Amen. He's trying to take you from Shur to Elim is the place of your blessing. 12 springs of water, 70 palm trees is there. But you know what? You're not patient enough. You don't want to learn. You are complaining. Ensure you're complaining. Why? Why I have to do this? Why I have to read the word? Why I have to pray? Very hard to pray. Name of the Father and the Son and the Holy. Sleep. Next morning, wake up. Spirit, amen. Notice, when you're watching Hindi movie, that time you're not sleepy. When you're gossiping, you're not sleepy. When you're playing pool, you're not sleepy. When you're praying, that's when you're sleepy. Why? Because your spiritual stamina is so weak. You've got to become strong. Say amen.
Amen.
You've got to discipline yourself. Because no Shur, no Elim. No such thing as shortcut. Tell the person sitting next to you. No shortcut. Say amen.
Amen.
So next time you feel sleepy, give yourself a slap in the face. And tell yourself, wake up. If you want your blessing, wake up. Tell the person sitting next to you, wake up. Amen. Do you want your 12 springs of water and 70 palm trees? Do you want? Yes. Do you want 70 palm trees, 12 springs of water? Do you want? Yes, brother, I want. Then go through your shore. Discipline yourself. Take the wood and put it in the water. This is how your life will be changed. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 20 to 22. Proverbs 4, 20 to 22. My child, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my saying. Do not let them escape from your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to all who find them and healing to all the flesh. Five things we can learn from that woman, friends. She had expectant faith. She believed the word of God. Just like at the crippled man at Lystra, he believed the word of God. He had expectant faith. That's why he was listening to the word of God. He had boldness. The woman with hemorrhage had boldness. If they had caught her, they would have stoned her to death, because the number of people she defiled, made unclean by pushing through the crowd. But she had boldness. Catholics today have laziness, but they want their healing. This woman had boldness. She focused on Jesus, not on the healing. Tell the person sitting on your right and left, focus on Jesus. Amen? Focus on Jesus. She had exhausted every method. She overcame her fear and her shame. She overcame her fear and her shame. And the consequence, the Bible says, Jesus looked for her. Amazing, yes? Not she looking for Jesus. Jesus looking for her. Jesus turned around and said, who touched me? The disciples said, Master, how can you ask that? So many people are touching you. Jesus said, no, somebody touched me. And the Bible says very specifically, Jesus turned and looked around to see who touched him. Jesus looked for her. Jesus knew there was this woman. Friend, when your faith is activated, you don't need to look for Jesus. Jesus will look for you. Say amen. Amen. Number two, in all recorded scripture, there was only one time Jesus ever called a woman daughter. This was the moment. Jesus called the woman daughter. You know why? Because the moment you know who you are, the moment you read the word of God, your identity changes. Say amen. Amen. You're no more a beggar. You're no more a pauper. You become the son and daughter of God. Say amen. Amen. He called her daughter. This is the only time Jesus addressed somebody daughter. Jesus said, your faith has healed you. Your faith has healed you. Faith in what? Faith in the living word of God has healed you. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. Friends, Jesus wants to touch you. He wants to heal you. But it's not abracadabra. Say amen. Amen. It's not magic. Are you ready to pay the price?
Yes, very soft. Sleepy, brother. Very sleepy. Don't you have coffee, brother?
Give yourself a slap in the face. Listen. Which is easier? Until it's so bad, you end up in the hospital and the doctors are putting all the tubes around you, and that time you say, I want to have faith. Or now. Now. Look at a person sitting next to you and tell them, don't wait till it's too late. Amen. When do you activate your faith? When do you begin to believe the word of God? Not tomorrow. now. Amen. So would you stand to your feet? We want to pray. Would you stand to your feet? We want to pray. We want to activate that faith. Amen. So that you can allow the power of the word of God to flow through you and to touch you and to change you. Close your eyes, stretch out your hands, both left hand and right hand, lift it up high and begin to praise the Lord out loud with me. Praise you, Jesus.